All right, you guys, welcome back to Blake's Exotic Animal. Today we're going to be cutting down all this sea grape, cutting it back a little because it's overgrowing too much inside my yellowfoot enclosure. I like to leave everything very tall and thick, like as you can see. We come right over here and there's a yellowfoot just hiding perfectly right here in a tall piece of grass. They think like they're in the wild here, and that's how I like to keep all my animals natural, as more as natural as I can. So yeah, we're cutting this back. The reason why I'm cutting it back also, if we come all over here, I planted a guava tree about 4 months ago and it's growing really big, but this sea grape is overtaking it. So I want to cut it back a lot so it has more areas for it to grow better, because that gives fruits for the tortoises. This doesn't do anything except shade. So I'd rather have fruits and shade instead of having just shade, if you guys know what I mean. So we use all the parts of our property as much as we can. So let's cut all this back and let's do this quick before this thunderstorm comes again. And I don't like being outside during thunderstorms, as you guys know. Let's do this. Yeah. And then all this stuff, you know where this goes, you guys? Straight to the goats. We'll throw it over there in a sec. We're throwing over the fence right now. The goats will eat everything. That's one good thing about having goats, is that all your extra leaves and sticks and everything, the leaves, goats will eat it all. Don't have to like throw it anywhere. Oh yeah. This was just cut probably about 2 months ago, and now with all these rains and everything we have, it just takes off. It literally just takes off. And this will become a humongous tree, but I wanted to grow a little higher up so that it's more of a big like umbrella here, so it's a little higher up. You guys have not subscribed to my channel yet, please make sure you guys smash that subscribe button so you guys can see my channel and you get notified so that you guys can know when every single time I post another video here at Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch. Make it into a big circle right here, and it'll be a big giant shade area for the tortoises, and we'll be able to see them a lot better. All right, you guys, this is my old chicken coop. I decided to make this into a new tortoise area because, if you guys remember, the whole barn went into flames, everything's gone over there. So I'm gonna take down a lot of these trees and different things and start putting dividers and put in juvenile tortoises that I purchased and buy from different people to start doing a new breeding colony and breeding facility and all different kinds of things for the animals in here. So I'm gonna cut back some of these big bushes and everything, start measuring and trying to figure out where I'm gonna put these dividers and everything. Don't worry about Maverick in the background. He's just really loud back there. Just block him out. And then I'm talking to you guys a little bit about my elongated tortoises and my black Burmese mountain tortoises also. So first, let's just take some of this stuff down. Where do I start? Oh yeah. As you see now, this whole bush is gone. So now you just pull this out and let the goats eat this too. Come on, goat. You got more trees for you. So now you guys can already see, it already looks twice the size. So I'm just taking this one bush out. But I'm literally gonna use every single square inch of this whole area for tortoises. I'm gonna divide it up in certain sizes, different sizes, and set it all up. I have a hose and everything in here also, so I can clean waters, I can do everything here. My mountain tortoises and everything are over here. If you guys can see, I have already cactus over here. I have a water area, but they make that water area completely dirty every single time. I have to figure out a better way so that's more cleaner more often. So if you guys have any ideas, put in the comments what you guys think. I have hibiscus trees and I have all sorts of different types of things in here so that the tortoises can eat. When I don't get produce or pellets from Missouri, I will pick off different things off the plants, throw it on the floor, and they'll scavenge for it just like if they're in the wild. I have no idea what kind of tree this is, so taking it down because I need plants and trees and bushes and things that tortoises can eat. So I want to take it down so I can replace it with something better for the tortoises so they can eat it. It's good for their diet. And here comes Captain right now, helping me out with the weed problem in here, which is awesome. There he goes. One leaf at a time. Every leaf counts. That was easy. I got the tree, you guys. So,
there you go.
And if it grows back again, I'll cut it off again. I'm not in the mood to take all the roots out. The goats, though, goats will eat anything. If they can't eat it, they know they can't eat it. They will literally eat everything. And they'll eat until they can't eat anymore. Their stomachs will get huge. They keep on eating. They'll stop, and they come back and eat more. It's funny. Taking the door down, you guys. Starting it over.
All right, skateboard style.
Come on, skater.
Yo.
You're weak.
Down right there.
Oh!
I'm gonna try this way.
Man, Blake, he got it. Look at that. Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
You guys, this is Exotic Ranch Construction.
Remember in the other video before when we were taking all the wood from my buddy's house? But now more of the wood is getting used right now. We're inside the chicken coop. So we're gonna take this in here and I'm gonna show you where I'm gonna put this right now. So down to the tortoises, get out. Alright. All right, you guys, there was a big door here. I didn't want the door anymore because I had it for the chickens. It's tortoises in here. So all I have to do now is I'm gonna put these right here so the tortoises can't get over this. It's gonna be juvenile tortoises. So juvenile tortoises won't be able to get over a 12-inch piece of wood. So that's how exactly I'm gonna put it right there. Look, here comes the mountain. This right here, you guys, is one of my Burmese mountain tortoises that I have. Look how pretty this thing is. This thing, I've had this guy for a real long time. One of the star tortoises that passed away, I got them both together when they were around this size. And this thing is becoming a monster. He's one of the fourth largest tortoise species in the world. And one day, hopefully, I'll be able to breed these guys. I'll tell you a little bit more in just a sec. All right, you guys, this section right here is a very large section. If you guys see those goat panels over there, they're 4x4 metal sheets that I'm gonna use to put around this whole section right here. And this whole section right here is gonna be for the yellowfoot tortoises. And the yellowfoot tortoise pin is gonna get moved for a different species of tortoise. So in the next week or two, I'm gonna be making this whole area into a giant tortoise enclosure. And the reason why I've picked this section is because these tortoises really like a lot of water. For some reason, that's what a lot of people have been telling me. So this whole area, when it floods up nice and high. So it's gonna be half water, half land when it's flooding. And then when it's normal, it's gonna look like this. So stay tuned for this. All right, you guys, we are gonna go into the mountain tortoise area. I'm gonna talk to you guys a little bit about the mountain tortoises, and make sure you guys go to the description and go purchase some of the new merch that I have here on the ranch. And yeah, let's go talk about the tortoises. All right, you guys, so these are Burmese black mountain tortoises. I have 5 of them total. There's one smaller one also, but I got this one, and this one together as a 1.2. 1.2 meaning this one right here is a male, and this is a female, and this is a female. I got them when they're all around this size. This female right here took off, and she is getting humongo. And then this one right here, I'm not 100% sure of the sex of it. Hopefully it is a female, so then I have a 1.3, so that would be amazing. But these guys get very large. They're the fourth largest tortoise in the world. When they breed and when they're laying eggs, these guys don't lay, they don't lay inside the dirt. What they do is they make a big mound like an alligator or a crocodile. So they find a nice spot somewhere in the enclosure. I'm gonna make a bigger enclosure, but somewhere in the enclosure, and you give them like leaves and hay and stuff like that, they make a big pile. And inside that pile, they'll lay all their eggs, and they'll actually guard their nest like crocodiles and alligators do also. And they'll actually charge you just like crocodiles and alligators do also. And it's a really neat species. They're one of the oldest Colonian species of tortoises. And I mean, they're awesome. They're bigger than the Burmese brown mountain tortoises. They get much larger than them. And maybe eventually in the future, I'll get the browns, but as of right now, I just have the blacks. And they're doing awesome. Hopefully one day I'm able to breed these guys. And yeah, let's get a better look at these eyes on these guys though. You guys look closely right here. Look at the eyes on that thing. It's insane. It looks like a dinosaur. But these guys are living in the mountains and stuff, and they like to wallow inside water holes. So what I'm gonna do is eventually make a big giant enclosure, and on top of a mountain, I'm gonna put a big water hole there. So they have to walk up, use their legs, and act like if it's a natural ecosystem and use their back legs and everything. Here, so it's gonna be a triangle enclosure right here. Then I'm gonna make another one this 4x4 to this 4x4 is going to be a whole enclosure right here. So this would be a kind of a larger one, and also another larger one here. I have no idea. Maybe you guys put in the comments what species of tortoises you think I should work with. Put in the comments which ones you guys think. And there's going to be another enclosure, back up a little more, right here on this other 4x4. And another one right here. I'm not gonna put any doors. I don't have to do anything like that because this whole thing is completely closed in. This was made for chickens and different stuff that I had. So no raccoons, nothing get inside of it. So all the tortoises would be protected. So all I would have to do is just walk over each one. I'll put bricks so I don't step in all the grass and the bushes and everything I planted here. The weeds will be gone. I'll make all these enclosures very naturalistic, make them look like for each species, for each environment. So if they're from Italy, I'll do plants from Italy. If they're from Madagascar, I'll do plants from Madagascar. Wherever those tortoises are from, those are the plants that are going to be there. So each one is going to have their exact same plants that they're supposed to be from. And this is going to be the end of the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up. And yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow in the next video. And I'll see you guys later. Peace out, you guys.